Welcome to Sentry 1. In this video, I will walk through the performance analysis interface and provide a brief look at the data that is presented in each of the tabs. Please note that each of these tabs will be described in more detail in different videos. Also of note is that the information shown on each of these tabs will be relevant to the time period shown in the toolbar. Let's begin by taking a look at the dashboard. On the left side of the dashboard, you are presented with the Windows metrics for your monitored server, and on the right side, you are presented with the SQL Server metrics for your monitored instance. If you are running in limited access mode, you will only be able to view the instance level metrics. In the Processes tab, you are presented with a list of processes that are running on your server, as well as the metrics related to the resource utilization of these processes. The TopSQL tab will display any potentially problematic queries and procedures that run on your instance. TopSQL also provides you with a look at the execution plan diagrams, as well as a history of the queries and procedures that have been captured by Sentry 1. The Blocking SQL tab presents a view of the blocking events that were collected on your server. This view provides different versions of the block depending on what SPIDs were being blocked and which SPID was the head blocker at the time. The Deadlocks tab provides a grid of the SPIDs that owned a lock on a resource, as well as the SPIDs that were waiting for that particular resource. The Deadlocks tab also presents you with a graphical representation of the deadlock, which allows you to easily identify the steps that led to the deadlock. As you can see, performance analysis within Sentry 1 Essentials allows you to gather and display detailed information about your monitored servers with these. If you have any questions about this information or you would like further assistance, please navigate to our support website at support.sentry1.com. Thanks for watching.